Hello everyone and welcome back to my stream. Tager Slayer here. We're going to play some battle scenarios and we will start with the light side and then the dark side. Thank you. We will start with tier 1 and then we will go with tier 2. So this might take a while. Alright, Luke Skywalker or Leia? I will be Luke.
I'm a Jedi, like my father.
Woohoo!
Rest if you have to, but we need you.
Woohoo! Wow. Play next tier. Oh damn. Oh damn. Not bad.
Be careful now.
Oh yeah. Damn. Woohoo! Yeah, victory! Thank you. Damn. Damn. Damn it. Ah! Oh, God damn it. No. All righty. Geonosis.
Trust me when I say trust me.
I wonder why. Yeah, come on, let's go! Let's do this!
Say scoundrel like it's a bad thing. Thank you.
No. And we'll do Attack of the Droids. Go. Holy crap. Victory!
Thank you. Oh my god. Damn it. No. Must face them. I'll be Chewy since I hate her.
Come on. Victory! No! It's all beer. Ugh. The strongest Jedi ever, eh? Can't even win it her either.
Boom! Do.
Trust me, I know exactly what I'm doing.
Oh, whoops.
Make an exit.
Let's go. Hey folks, 1 second. And folks, here he is, DJ the Gamer. On my Twitch.
Oh. Hello, Twitch chat.
Nobody's on tonight, for frig's sakes. Kind of pissing me off.
Now you know how I feel.
Oh, I know it, man. Like, I marked my arse off.
That's the whole reason I stopped live streaming on Twitch. It was the very same reason.
Yeah.
If you live stream on YouTube, I tell you, it's a different crowd over there.
I live streamed on YouTube and nobody came on before. I don't mind
Twitch.
It also
depends. Yeah, it also depends on the size of your channel too.
True, my channel's not that big. I only got like 38 followers, which isn't too bad though.
Yeah, I have 81 followers on my Twitch.
Oh, look at him flexing! Love it.
I had 1,000 at one point, but I stopped
really?
Streaming. So. Yeah, I actually had 1,000 at one point.
Oh wow!
And they all left because I stopped streaming on Twitch. Even though I had 1,000, and I'd pull a bunch of people watching, no one would comment or say anything, so I just...
Yeah, I hate that.
I announced it on one of my streams and said, this is it, I'm leaving Twitch forever. No one's... I don't get any sort of reaction from the audience, so I'm out.
I do now and again, like, I get, like, some people commenting and then following, you know what I mean?
Hello.
Yeah, I know, I've seen.
I've said hello, just as a joke, like, hello.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Oh no! What are you playing?
Absolutely nothing.
Oh no, you just got on?
I just came back from a Timmy's run.
Literally
a Timmy's within a 5-minute walk of my apartment. I was in a predicament earlier.
Uh-oh.
So, as you know, I moved recently. Mm-hmm. And so the place I was at actually had on-site laundry. It was a basement apartment, so it had like laundry machines as part of the place. And that was so cool. I didn't have to go anywhere to do my laundry.
There you go.
Here, there was no on-site laundry.
Oh, no.
So I have to go to, like, a laundromat. So yeah. I went to the launcher mat, and boy, did I feel like an idiot. So there's a machine there where you put in like 5s, 10s, or 20s, and it's supposed to give you like quarters and loonies and toonies for the machines.
Yeah.
Well, the machine was broken and was not accepting my bills. So a random dude's like, here, I can give you change for one of your fives. I said, sure, that's awfully nice. So I used it, and then I was an idiot. So I wanted to break one of the loonies I had for quarters. Because, hilariously enough, it's $5 for a load. $7 if you want to do like a mega load. It's stupid.
Hmm.
You know?
Oh, yeah, it sounds stupid.
Yeah, it's like $5 for a load to use the smallest machine, $7 to use the big machine.
Wow.
Alright. And then, to make it even worse, not all the machine, both sets of machines, the dryer and the washer, don't take the same currency. So, like,
you're
going to use dollars, like $1 or $2 coins for the washer. Well, guess what? You now have to have a separate stash of quarters just for the dryers.
No.
Yeah.
That's where they got you, though.
Yeah, it's stupid.
That's where they get you. Yep.
And so, of course, I acted like a fool because I broke one of the loonies. I was unaware that you needed the quarters. So, unfortunately, I haven't done laundry since I got here.
No.
It's been 3 weeks.
Wow.
Yeah. I've basically been wearing mostly dirty clothes for 3 weeks.
What can you do, though, man? Like, what can you do?
I know.
Hopefully it figures out soon.
Luckily, I have workers that can help me out, so...
Isn't that great?
Yeah, I'm with an association.
Nice.
It's called CLD.
Nice.
I'm sure you've heard of that stuff, like community living. I'm sure you've heard of that
before. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's like an organization with people with, like, special needs, and they have, like, group homes and...
Nice.
...independent living areas and such. I was in a group home, and I hated it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it sucked.
Did not know that.
I don't care, Twitch. You can learn my history if you want. I could care less about sharing this stuff. Most people like would be all personal, but I don't really care.
No.
But yeah, the group home I was at there. I moved into the group home, which was in the same town. It was in where I live now, in a different part of town. And I moved there in December of 2013, the first day of December 2013.
Okay. Wow.
And when I was first there, I was treated like a child.
Oh, no.
When I was first there. So let's say the staff had to go somewhere, pick someone up from a location or a store or something. I would have to go with them. I wasn't allowed to stay home. I was and I'm 17, okay? I'm a 17-year-old kid at this point. All right, I'm old enough.
Yeah.
And they won't let me stay home. And this carried on for months. And then when it came to doing my laundry, they had the laundry machines there, too. When it came to doing my laundry, I wasn't even allowed to do that on my own in the very beginning. Staff had to come down and supervise me to do it.
Wow.
Yeah, I was being treated like a child. The thing is, that was an independent living transitional house. So it's one of those group homes where you're there for a few years, you learn your skills to move out on your own, then you leave.
Yeah.
In the beginning, it did not feel that way.
No.
Nope. So one time, I'll tell you something funny. So one time, I was getting sick and tired of the staff. supervising me with my laundry. So one time, I waited until the staff were all next door, because there was two sides. It was a duplex house. So originally, when it was purchased, the other side was just a regular someone's own house, but they ended up buying it, and both sides are, not connected, but
no.
Anyway, so Saffron next door, I can quickly switch my loads. So I go down there, I quickly shut the laundry room door, right? Here I am swapping soap and swapping the loads right from the washer to the dryer real quick.
Yeah.
Staff ends up coming back, and I guess they could hear me switching the loads, and they saw me come back up from the laundry room, and they're like, I told you had to wait for me. I'm like, I ain't waiting for you. This is an independent house. I'm doing it by myself, so screw you. And they're like, don't talk to me that way. I'm like, I'm telling you how it is. I did not care one bit. And luckily, the supervision with the laundry ended very quickly after that because I spoke out about it.
Wow.
And they have like a manager of the house that listens to any sort of complaints. Mm-hmm. And I complained about it enough, and they said to the staff, they said, you need to put him along when he does his laundry. And they're all like, well, we're afraid he's going to overload the machine. I'm like, and I told them off, I'm like, dude, I lived
who
at another
cares
house
if you do?
Where I did laundry on my own for like 3 years. What's your problem?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man, it was great. And then the Wi-Fi.
Oh, God, here we go.
You're going to love this. All right, Twitch, you ready for this? You ready for this story, too? I actually love telling stories like this on your Twitch. It makes it more entertaining.
It's all right. It's all right. It's all
yeah,
good.
I love doing that. Twitch deserves to hear these hilarious stories. All right, so the Wi-Fi. Right now, as I've told you before, my Wi-Fi is pretty good. 24 up, 24 down right now. That's pretty good. And I haven't had any issues, no lag or anything like that. And sure enough, at the group home, now I'm not going to specify where the group home is. Just
No, that's fine.
Yeah, it's actually a rule, actually, with the organization. You're not allowed to say where the home is. You're not allowed to say any of the staff's names or
oh, yeah.
people that
that's
live
fine.
Or... It's a confidentiality thing. Anyway,
yeah.
So,
yeah, no problem.
The Wi-Fi. You're going to love this. So, the Wi-Fi was on a timer.
Uh-oh.
You see. So, one time, and this is back in 2015, right when I got my PS3, because mm-hmm. a buddy of mine had it, and he was selling it for $300, and he told me he was selling it, and I told him that I was potentially interested in maybe buying the PS3. And I said, how much are you willing to sell it for? He's like, $300. Mm-hmm. And I'm like... I don't think I'm
yeah.
that interested now. I told him, how about you lower the price, get back to me on what you lower the price as, and then maybe I'll reconsider.
Exactly.
He's like, okay. He says, let me give it a week or two, and I'll think about it. And I'm like, okay. You know, I didn't rush him or anything. And about a week or two later, he comes back to me. He says, all right, I lowered the price. And I said, mm-hmm. Give it to me. What do you think? It says, I'll give you the whole PS3, HDMI, AV, controller, and including GTA 4 for $120. How about that? I said,
wow.
You get yourself a deal. And the funny thing is, when I got the PS3, which also took a
yeah.
long time, too, I asked one of the staff, and she was like a British lady,
mm-hmm.
and I asked her, I said, hey, buddy over there, sell me the PS3. Can we sign off on it? And so she asked both me and him. That's
mm-hmm.
what we wanted to do. Because in order to technically buy stuff, we had to sign off for it.
Oh, okay.
Because there was issues in the past where people would sell stuff to somebody and then they would immediately kind of, you know, want it back. They'd be like those kind of people. Like, oh, I kind of want that back now. And
okay.
created issues. So they had this form where you would sign it. And basically the idea was once you signed it, there was no going back. So once you signed off, let's say you were selling an iPhone to somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Once you signed off on the fact that you sold your iPhone to that other person, that means you can't have that back, no matter
yeah.
how much you regret it or anything. Anyway, so we signed off, and I asked her if we could go to the bank at some point, take out the $120 so I can make the payment for the console. And she says, okay, we'll do it next week, Wednesday or something. And I'm like, okay, cool. And I left her alone and went to do my thing. Next week, Wednesday comes. I was like, okay, are we going to go to the bank? And she's like, oh, sorry. We'll do it next week, I promise. Next week comes by. Can we go to the bank? He's like, and she just kept pushing it. She just kept
oh, wow.
pushing it back. So he had this thing up for sale. I want to say late April, early May is when he had this thing up for sale. And that's when we talked about it and we signed it off. Eventually, the lady, this is now... I'm going to say, we're fast-forwarding now.
Mm-hmm.
We're in August.
No,
we're
wow.
in late July, August. And guess what?
What?
I still don't have the bloody console.
Oh, my God.
It's been like 4 months. 4 or 5 months at this point.
That's crazy, folks. That is crazy.
I did not have the console. Finally, I go to a different staff. The British lady was on a vacation. So I went to a different staff.
Mm-hmm.
And I asked her. She was also a female. And I asked her, can we get this $120? I said, I asked the other lady, and she kept saying we'd go to the bank over and over and over, but we never went because she kept putting it off. And the other lady's like, Alright, I'm grabbing the car keys. Let's get in the car. Let's go to the bank. Literally just one time asking.
Wow.
On the same day, within minutes. Like, okay, let me grab the keys. We'll grab your bank card, all your stuff, and we'll head out to the bank. And me and my buddy and the staff went out to the bank. We exchanged. We signed everything off. And within that day, I had the console, GTA 4, and everything. Now, where the Wi-Fi comes into play is about a week later, my buddy said, hey, I could share GTA 5 with you. You know how you could do that? You could share games with your buddies, so if you had your buddy's account, you could share a game that you purchased, and you'd be able to play the full game.
Okay.
So long as he didn't get rid of it. That was something you could do on PS3. Mm-hmm. So he shared me, like, the full game of Minecraft and all this cool, awesome stuff, right? And anyway, he said, hey, I could get you the full download of GTA 5. I would later get it on disc, but this is before
that.
Yeah. And he says, I can share you GTA 5 if you want.
Wow.
And I said, okay, cool, thanks. Let's do it. And so he starts the download. We started the download on a Saturday.
Now, wow.
As I said before, the Wi-Fi was on a timer. It would shut off at 11 o'clock at night.
No.
Every night. It would just shut off. Now, the people in the office could still use the internet, but it would just, the signal would just go out. And it was on a timer, and it wouldn't come back on again. It wasn't like it'd come back on at like 1 in the morning or something. No. It would come back on at 7 in the morning.
Wow.
I'm done. So all those hours. So to download GTA 5 took a while.
Oh, yes.
And the Wi-Fi there, it wasn't like my current Wi-Fi where it's, you know, I couldn't even watch YouTube properly on that Wi-Fi.
Oh, no.
To watch a 1080p video, even a 720p video, it would immediately struggle. If I played a video and I hit auto, because you can do that on YouTube, you can, if your Wi-Fi is struggling to set, to use it at the certain picture quality, you can set to auto and it'll auto. Whenever I would hit auto, it would just drop right down to like 480 or 144p.
Wow.
It was so bad.
Jeez.
To, like, to download like an example, like let's say I had a software update on my PS3, and it was probably, you know, maybe a gig or 2 gigs worth of software update, like a big update. Here, it would probably take 15, maybe 20 minutes max, which is not bad. And with that Wi-Fi, 4 hours.
Jesus.
4 hours, because it was so slow. We were only pulling, I think, we weren't even pulling megabytes. We were pulling like 500 kilobytes. Like, it was slow. So GTA 5, we downloaded it on a Sunday, or Saturday, I mean. You wonder how long it took? It's a 74-gigabyte game. You might think it took a couple hours, right?
Nope, days.
Try a whole
week. Oh, wow.
A whole week. So, just remember, I downloaded it. We started the download on a Saturday. Just remember that. I didn't play it until that following Sunday.
Jesus.
I didn't finally play it, then start up like the prologue and all that other stuff. I didn't do any of that until the following Sunday. I'm not even joking.
Wow, yeah, folks. Wow.
Yeah.
DJ the Gamer? Holy Jesus.
I had to deal with that, too. Even, like, live streaming, for instance, I could not live stream in 720p on my PS4. I had to live stream in 360p.
Wow.
So a lot of my early streams on my channel are just super low quality. But that's all I could do back then.
That's crazy.
And the funny thing is, they kept, while I was there, they kept talking of upgrading the Wi-Fi to a better service. They kept mentioning that. They kept saying, oh, we plan on upgrading the Wi-Fi. Sure enough, they actually end up doing that after I leave. After I leave, they upgrade the Wi-Fi. Yeah, and the funny thing is, the new Wi-Fi, as far as I've heard, is not on a timer.
Yeah, either. It's probably because whenever you were there.
Well, apparently the timer was set because certain people would just stay up on the Wi-Fi all night.
Oh.
So originally, before I even got there, before I even moved in, apparently there was actually no timer on the Wi-Fi.
Wow.
And, but like I said, that was like well before I moved in. And then I moved to my other place, and it had decent Wi-Fi, but it had issues.
Crazy.
Dark roast. I had
Oh, that's what that was?
Yeah, nice little dark roast. I usually go for that.
Nice.
Drink it black. If you're ever drinking coffee, what do you have in yours? I take mine black.
I honestly do not drink coffee, man. It's not that good for me.
Oh, does it like, not agree with you, or just...
Yeah, like and my heart races. Like, I'm very allergic to caffeine, kind of, like yeah.
Yeah, if you have caffeine, it just doesn't... Yeah, caffeine doesn't bother me at all. Like, I could, like, drink a full extra-large coffee right before bed and go race.
Oh, wow.
Literally. I've never done it, but I've had coffee before. There was one time I had, actually just a couple days ago, I had coffee around midnight.
Oh,
and
wow.
And within half an hour, right to bed.
Oh, right to bed.
Yeah, literally didn't stay up, didn't wow. like take a while for the caffeine to wear off, just like that. But, yeah, the Wi-Fi at my other place, it was not bad. It was better Wi-Fi. It was Rogers. Now the original
Rogers.
Wi-Fi. Yeah, the original Wi-Fi. I'll tell you who it was with, and this will show you why it was bad. It was with Whiteman Telecommunications.
Never heard of them.
They're really bad.
Sounds
They're really bad. Yeah, yeah. So the new Wi-Fi when I moved, it got Wi-Fi. It was with Rogers. And it worked pretty well. It was pretty fast in the beginning. But as I lived at my other place for a little while, the Wi-Fi started having weird oddities. So, for example, if I was on, like, my PS4 menu, which I'm on right now...
Yes.
You know, I'd be cycling through my message groups. There'd be times where it would just randomly just refuse to load.
No,
even
wow.
though I was connected. It would just randomly do that, randomly. So it'd be, like, completely fine. So, you know, I'd go down and I could see all the names of all the people and everything, right?
Yeah.
And then, as I would scroll back up, all of a sudden it would just unload everything. So everything would just... It would, like, I could still, like, scroll up and down, but just nothing would load. The
wow.
same thing would happen on YouTube, too, where just random part... I'd be watching a YouTube video and all of a sudden it would just start buffering out of nowhere. And it was a good Wi-Fi, although it barely, I think it could, it had two connections. It had a regular connection, which was probably pulling like 7 megabytes per second.
Wow.
And like probably like 4 or 5 megabytes. Megabytes per second upload would have been like around 7 to 10. And then like download was probably like 4 to 6. But on the 5G connection, you want to know how bad this was? Upload speed was, I think, genuinely, it was like 34 megabytes or somewhere in there.
Yeah.
Which was not bad. Download, however, was 320-something kilobytes.
Wow.
That's bad.
Yeah.
And also, the Wi-Fi would be selective sometimes. I had this happen quite a bit while I lived there. And what I mean by that is, like, the one time... When it was being selective, what would happen is my phones and everything would connect just fine. So, like, my iPhones would connect, all that stuff. But then something like my PlayStation wouldn't, but my Xbox would. And it was very weird like that. And I would try and connect on my PlayStation, and it would just say that there's no connection or whatever. And I'm thinking, okay, my Xbox is connected. Why won't the PlayStation connect? And it did that more than once, and I would just have to go up there and, like, do it, but then it got to the point where we were banned from being upstairs.
Like, wow.
I could no longer... Yeah, the landlord hated our guts. But that's only because we caught her for, you know, cheating and stuff. Not
oh,
cheating,
wow.
but stealing, I mean. She would steal food from us and such.
Huh.
Yeah, she'd steal stuff from us, break our things, and... whatnot.
Great.
And, yeah, it was not cool. It's, you know.
Yeah.
Even before I left, for instance, the Friday before I left, she even came down just on her own to use my roommate's toaster oven without his
permission. That's random.
My roommate had gone to work, and I had just finished cleaning up because I'd made some sausages for lunch that day, and he went to work and said her goodbyes, and I went to my room to watch Disney Plus for a little while and play some games on my PlayStation, and about 4 hours later, I could just hear the toaster oven going ding, and I'm thinking in my head, you know, I didn't want to go out and spook anybody, but in my head, I'm thinking,
who the hell is there?
Yeah. Yeah, like, and it was later confirmed by my roommate where he confronted, because I told him that I think someone was using your toaster oven, and I think it might have been the landlord and her friend.
Wow.
But I told him, I'm not sure, because, you know,
yeah.
I didn't see anything, so I couldn't say it was them, like, definitively, because I didn't know, you know.
Exactly.
I couldn't. Yeah. So I said, I think it might have been them. And then, he confronted them about it, and sure enough, it was true.
Oh.
They did use it. And their excuse was, the landlord's excuse was, and she said it in a comical tone, just like this, and to which you're going to love it. The landlord was like, oh, I've never used a toaster oven before. I thought I would try it out, yeah.
Oh my god.
Straight up, that was her excuse. Her excuse was, I never used a toaster oven before, so she wanted to try it.
We have someone on the stream right now, but I have to go for a sec.
Okay.
Yeah, so we're going to continue on these battle scenarios. We're going to be on Hope. Whenever I come back, we'll continue. Okay, be right back.
Someone scored. Hi, chat. DJ the Gamer here. I used to be a Twitch streamer. Not anymore. Twitch was not good to me.
And we're back.
Yep.
Sorry, folks, that you had to listen to DJ talk, if you did any at all. Just joking, buddy.
Didn't really talk much.
No, that's okay. Awkward silence. Whew. I'm good now. How's your day today, bud?
Oh, my day?
Yeah,
it's been alright.
That's okay. I know I'm Twitch streaming, so you probably don't want to talk about too much, but...
Yeah, it's mostly just a typical day. Went to work, stuff like that.
Yeah, you work in a school, you said, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, so how long have you been at that particular school?
I think it'll be 5 years this year.
Nice, you like it?
Yeah, it's good. I went there, I was at another school and they kind of tossed me out.
They tossed you out? Why?
Yeah.
Oh, if you don't want to talk about it, you don't have to.
Well, it was nothing bad, it was more of like a cost-saving measure. They were saving money by having like the parents volunteer instead of actually paying, you know, employees, you know?
Oh, okay. Yeah. What is it that you do for work again? Isn't it like supervisor for people with disabilities, isn't it?
No, it's just like a recess, like supervisor.
Recess supervisor, sorry.
Yeah.
So it's a grade 1 to 6?
No, it's kindergarten to grade 8.
Kindergarten to grade 8, wow. Wow. Huh. That's pretty, that would keep you on your toes. You'd be busy a lot.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining the stream again, person. You can talk so I know that you're there. Don't be shy, I'm not gonna hurt you. Just need the feedback and the views, you know. Oh yeah, they're gonna try to get me in a hole here. Great. Wonderful. Oof. 3 more and then I win. 2 more. Come on, where are yous? Ah. One more. Yeah. We did it, guys. We did it. Figure out what game you're gonna play or no?
I'm just on YouTube right now.
Nice. Checking out your channel, are you?
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on the Johnny Depp and Amber Heard trials?
I don't know. I haven't really been following it.
No? Yeah, neither have I. I've just been seeing stuff about it. She is crazy. Like, I already knew that, but she is fucked. I hope Johnny gets the truth out. I hope it's justice for Johnny. She is fucked, my friend. Even Jason Momoa wants her out as thing.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Not on GTA with the crew tonight?
No.
That's surprising.
I mean, there was really, like, no one on, really.
Yeah. Our buddy Casual's on.
He was, but he wasn't, like, he was in the party, but he was more or less in game chat.
Oh, again?
Yeah.
He always does that.
Yeah.
16 left. Ah! Frick! This one's gonna be hard, folks. 30 seconds. Can I get someone? No.
I got your back.
Oh my God, my God. No. No! Oh, we lost, folks. We lost.
That was
a hard one. Shit. Yeah, I got a couple more, and then I have the Dark Side one to do, and then after that we can personal chat if you want.
Yeah.
Totally up to you. Hello, person, can you talk?
Uh-huh.
I mean, at least you're watching the videos, but
yeah.
I'd like to know who you are, huh?
That's how I felt on Twitch.
I don't know. I enjoy Twitch because, like, see, I do the Twitch streams and then I export it over to my YouTube.
Yeah.
See, if you did it from YouTube, you couldn't export it to Twitch, you know what I mean? So that's why I like doing that.
Say hello,
but you're obviously
yeah.
Mr. Obi-Wan Kenobi, here we go. What are your thoughts for Obi-Wan series? You excited?
Who knows?
You don't know yet?
No, I haven't watched Star Wars in years.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's great to know that you are Canadian, my friend.
Yeah.
Whenever I found that out, whenever you first told me, I was like, oh yes. Us Canadians have to stick together.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to the summertime.
Yeah.
It's only a couple months away.
You need to stop. I mean, I like the summer and I don't like the summer. I find it just goes by really quick, so just enjoy it how you can.
True. That is quite true.
Come on, folks. We're almost dead here, guys. No! I had two left and I just died. I have a minute, 4 seconds left to kill two people. Okay, got one person, one kill left. Hello. Yes.
My controller is gonna die soon, so I will change it when it dies. Thank you again, DJ the Gamer, for allowing Twitch to hear your stories. I really appreciate it. Or did you leave? Well, you probably left and didn't even hear a word I said.
What's that?
Oh, I was thanking you for allowing Twitch to hear your stories of some of your past, my friend.
Yeah.
It takes a lot of guts to talk about stuff like that.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm glad we live on this planet.
What, Canada?
No, just planet in general.
Oh. Why is that?
I'm just happy to live here.
That's good. Happy to be alive, eh?
Aside from what's going over in the east. That's unfortunate. But it's not as severe as it once was.
Oh, you mean like the dispute?
Yeah.
Yeah, has it been...
It actually has died down quite a bit, to be really honest.
Yeah, I just hope it's finished soon.
It probably will. I heard that the Russian president actually might get ousted. I actually heard.
Might get ousted?
Yeah, kicked out of office.
Oh, wow, yeah, I heard that too.
Apparently in November, he actually will probably get kicked out.
Which
at
wow.
that point, once he does, his country's troops will leave Ukraine, and it'll be over.
Yeah.
It's not a World War situation. That was already disputed from the very beginning. It's not going to be a Cold War, it's not going to be a World War, or even a nuclear war. Like, the nuclear threats in the beginning, everyone's saying, oh, it's going to be a nuclear war. Those threats, you notice that... That he hadn't made any more nuclear threats since that first one. It's true. And plus, they're not even going for the central Ukraine anymore. They're more on the east and south now. They're kind of on the outskirts now.
Exactly, yeah.
They're no longer in the middle. So that's what I mean, how it's like, it's still bad. Like, it's still bad what's going on. And it's still devastating, but it's not as intense as it was in the very beginning.
Yeah.
Because Ukraine's been holding their ground, but there's not as many Russian troops over there as there originally was.
Yeah, exactly.
Which is, you know, my facts are pretty true, to be honest. Like, in the very beginning, that was all my YouTube search history was literally that. And it was causing me so much stress.
I know, buddy.
That I had to unsubscribe from all the news channels.
Wow.
Usually conflicts like that don't bother me because they happen all the time. It's just part of life. you know, sure. There'll never really ever be a world war again. That is such an unlikely scenario.
Hmm. We hope.
Everyone knows that. Well, all the countries, aside from Ukraine and Russia, all the rest of the countries are at peace with one another.
Yeah.
The only two that are angry at each other are Russia and Ukraine right now. That's it. Everyone else is just kind of doing their thing.
All right, we are going to play as Darth Maul, folks. Here we go. Yeah, sorry, DJ. Continue. Well,
that's what I mean. All the other countries are at peace with one another.
Yeah.
And so, and plus, Russia can't really fight any longer with their economical situation anyway. Once they run out of money, they'll have to leave.
Yeah, that's the thing. Their money's not doing too good.
No. Yeah. I thought the situation was going to be much worse than what it actually was.
True.
In the end, it really, like, it was devastating, but it wasn't, like, the media made it much worse than it was.
Oh, I know.
They did destroy a good chunk of Ukraine, but not that much of Ukraine, though.
Yeah, but
the media always makes things much worse than they actually are.
True, but I mean, Russia blew up, like, children hospitals, though.
Yeah, but still.
That's pretty fucked, though, man.
Yeah, but that's really the only thing that can fall out, really.
And then Russia goes on saying that it's Ukraine that did that? Yeah, okay, then.
No, they're just trying to take attention away from themselves. Because originally, at the very beginning, this wasn't even supposed to be an attack. They weren't planning on attacking. It was just more of a special military operation.
Well, that changed quickly.
It did, because Ukraine wasn't sure what was going on.
Oh, yeah.
I think if Ukraine left it alone, they could have done their military operation. It probably would have been weaponless, too. They probably just would have went over there, did what they had to do, and just leave.
You actually believe that that's what Russia was doing?
Not entirely.
Okay.
I believe it was going to be an invasion because they did this in 2014, as we know.
Oh.
Remember in 2014 they invaded Ukraine? And it took a while for them to deal with it.
Wow.
I guarantee in a year's time, it'll be over. Yeah.
If we're lucky.
I think it'll be fine. Think about the war in Afghanistan and Iraq, you know. And, you know, in the beginning, that was kind of like this, where it was like nuclear threats and all that. But then, of course, as we all know, that never happens. See, Russia knows. And Putin himself even said, in the end, that he would likely never fire nukes at anybody.
Yeah.
Because he knows the circumstances. He even said that during this conflict. In the end, he said he likely would not fire the nukes. It was more of just a warning to the West not to interfere. That's really all it was. He was never planning on firing them. You know, because if he did, he would have already done it by now, if you think about it.
Oh, yeah, but when someone says that, what do you do, right?
Yeah, of course, you stay alert and just make sure. But I knew in my conscience, I knew nothing was going to come of that. You know?
Yeah.
I knew that it wasn't going to come. I knew it was just a threat. You
know? So. Yeah.
But I'm going to move on from it. I haven't been paying any attention to it, and I don't know what happened.
That's good.
I know it'll sort itself out somehow. Like,
yeah, we hope.
Yeah, I'm just not that concerned about it.
No.
Because things like that happen on this planet quite often, and just it's kind of part of life. You know, the whole Afghanistan thing, that was a conflict, Iraq was a conflict. So stuff like that happens quite often, and that's just how the world is.
Oh, yeah. Do-do-do, come on, Darth Maul.
Yeah.
Come on, Darth Maul. Holy fuck.
I'm gonna head out still.
Alright, thanks for popping by.
Yep, probably gonna head over to the PS3, I think.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Still play that from time to time, so.
At least you don't have to wait a while to get it again.
Yeah, I know, that was annoying. Like I said, it took like 4 or 5 months just to get it.
Oh, yeah.
All because of that one staff that kept saying, oh, we'll do it, and then never ending up doing it.
Yeah, you're just like, I want to get it, huh?
Yeah.
Want to get it before he sells it to somebody else.
Yeah, well, he was holding it. He did say that.
Oh, he was holding it for you? Nice.
Yeah, he said he wouldn't sell it to anyone else if I ended up.
Okay.
He said he said in the beginning he would only sell it to someone else if, whatever reason, I was unable to
get it or whatever.
Yeah, so. Anyway.
Okay, nice.
Alright, well, I'm gonna split, so.
It sounds good, man. Thanks for coming by. Play the next tier. Damn it. And folks, that is it for this stream tonight. An hour and 43 minutes. We will continue with this tomorrow as dark.